I am Dr. Anand Alurkar. I am an interventional neurologist or stroke specialist working at KM Hospital, Pune since last 20 years. I'll be speaking in brief about stroke or paralysis today. What is stroke or paralysis? It is basically the disease of the brain which is caused by a problem in the blood supply to the brain, wherein the blood supply either gets blocked or there is bleeding in the brain. In either case, there is a damage to the brain causing the symptoms. The symptoms can be very mild to even death at home, can be very severe also. Now, how to recognize stroke? I always tell my patients or I always tell people that stroke should be recognized at home itself. Just as heart attack is mostly recognized as at home, the symptoms are very widely known. Similarly, stroke should also be recognized at home. Now, how do we do that? Now, remember that when the patient or your family member gets symptoms or a problem on one side of the body and the problem comes suddenly or very acutely within minutes, then it is very, very likely to be a stroke. For example, the patient can develop visual loss on one side, patient can develop deviation of the mouth while speaking, there can be slurring of speech while speaking, suddenly one arm or one leg can develop weakness, or there might be tingling on one side of the one half of the body, or the patient might suddenly start losing balance to one side. So symptoms coming on suddenly on one side of the body are very likely to be a stroke. Now, why is recognizing stroke immediately so important? Because the treatment of stroke and the outcome of stroke is very much dependent on how early the treatment is started. I'll come to it later. Now, what about the risk factors for stroke? Who are the patients who are more likely to develop stroke? Patients who have diabetes, blood pressure, especially if it is not controlled properly, patients who are smokers, obese patients, patients with high cholesterol, patients who have a strong family history of heart disease and stroke, these are the persons who are more likely to develop stroke. Stroke is a very common disease. If you go to any major hospital, ICU of any major hospital, probably one third to one half of all patients you will find they are stroke patients. In fact, stroke in the hospital setting is commoner than even heart attack, which is not a very easily recognized fact. Coming back to the early recognition, why is recognizing the symptoms of stroke early and fast so important? Because treatment of stroke, if started very early, can cause dramatic improvement in stroke. For example, we have two types of therapies. One therapy is where we give an injection to dissolve the clot which is blocking the blood vessel in the brain. This is called intravenous thrombolysis. Now, if this is started within first few hours, within first 3 or 4 hours of the onset of symptoms, it is very likely that the clot will dissolve, and we have seen improvement within minutes or in a day or two, which would happen in over a few months if this treatment is not given. The second type of early and very effective and dramatic treatment is called mechanical thrombectomy, wherein if the patient comes a bit late, not within the first 3 hours, and if a very large vessel of the brain is blocked, we take the patient in the cath lab, we go inside the blood vessel of the brain and we remove the clot by means of a special stent, which is a removable stent. This procedure is called mechanical thrombectomy. Both these procedures, if started early, have got very good results, sometimes even dramatic results. And as you know, a stroke, if not treated early, can leave the patient disabled, sometimes throughout life, or at least sometimes 1 or 2 years. The whole family is disturbed, the financial situation of the family becomes worse. So that is why going to the hospital, a well-equipped hospital, as soon as you recognize these symptoms of stroke is extremely important. Now, how to prevent stroke? There is something called as a TIA, transient ischemic attack. Just to give a simile, a patient of heart attack, before he actually develops a major attack, sometimes has mild chest pain, which is going on for a few weeks to months. Similarly, before the major stroke event, many patients, about one third of patients, they have these minor episodes wherein the symptoms which I had described earlier, they last only for a few minutes. So slurring of speech just for a couple of minutes, deviation of the face while speaking just for a couple of minutes. Most of these cases, the patient or even the family doctor neglects these symptoms. It is just labeled as weakness or low sugar or high BP or low BP, and it is neglected. Now, the importance of these symptoms is that the body is trying to give us a signal. It is trying to give us a warning that something major is about to happen and you have to seek urgent medical treatment. So if these symptoms occur in your family members, even if they have recovered within a few minutes, one has to go to a major hospital, well-equipped hospital, consult a neurologist and investigate for the risk factors, whether the patient has diabetes, high cholesterol, whether there is any blockage in the brain. And we have many procedures nowadays where we can, by either medical treatment or by surgeries, we can totally prevent a major stroke from happening. Thank you very much.